Diamond is the hardest known material. It also has the highest sound velocity. It has the highest electron and hole mobilities, and that's what makes it a better electronic material. It has the highest atomic number density of any material known to man outside of a neutron star, and that's what gives it these amazing properties. The newest diamond in the world. For a long time, diamond was thought to only form under high pressure and temperature. Well, the first time I came into contact with this idea of growing diamond at low pressure and low temperature was when I came across the work by John Angus, who was at Case Western. He was ridiculed for that idea because people had assumed that based on the pure carbon phase diagram that a diamond will never grow at low pressure and low temperature. People had looked at the pure carbon phase diagram and saw that diamond was unstable at low pressure and low temperature, and they extrapolated from that to all systems. And whenever anyone presented work of diamond at being formed at low pressure and low temperature, people presented the carbon phase diagram, the pure carbon phase diagram, as evidence why that could not happen. The error there is that what we're doing is not using a pure carbon situation. We're actually using carbon with hydrogen. In our specific case, we use plasma to dissociate hydrogen to atomic hydrogen, and plasma is another state of matter entirely and is not normally represented in a phase diagram. We think the atomic hydrogen that's formed by the plasma is able to preferentially etch the graphitic bonds, thereby enabling the system to form diamond instead of graphite. And so if you look at the energetics of the situation, the system gains a lot of energy by depositing carbon from a carbon-hydrogen mixture, and that is given by the phase diagram. You start with a diamond seed, you place that in your chamber, you then evacuate the atmosphere. Then we feed highly pure gases of methane and hydrogen. There can be other sources of carbon to the mixture. We just choose methane and hydrogen. In fact, it's been shown that you can make diamond out of whiskey or any other material that has carbon. Diamonds are already making an impact on the highest performance of detectors, particle detectors and radiation detectors, for example, used in the Large Hadron Collider. We'll see a transition from these early applications of electronic diamond into more commonplace devices, such as maybe power handling, power switching devices. But unfortunately, we still have to wait a while before we see it in things like PCs and cell phones. Well, these are single crystal diamonds that we've grown and sent to a traditional gemologist to cut into gems. So this is called a American standard cut or bullion cut. And it is equivalent to the gem that you find in the ground, except it was made right here in the lab. It's very exciting to be able to be in a position to launch this material that is of outlandish properties. Wherever we measure diamond, it has astonishing properties that are just much higher than anything else. And it's never been available as an engineering material before. So we're starting to be able to utilize these properties and to enable them to come into the marketplace.